don't know about you, but I love trees. Trees are fantastic. Not only are they beautiful on the eye, they also serve a very important role in maintaining our inhabitable environment. Most of us know that trees help clean the air and produce oxygen, but they actually have a lot of life-saving functions. We need trees. But what if there were none left? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, the channel that looks to answer many a question. Easy, medium, or hard, we're not afraid. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate, and today I'm asking a super scary question. What would happen if all of the trees disappeared? Before we get into the video, why don't you guys let me know your favorite type of tree? Mine is most definitely the palm tree. Also, they have coconuts. What more do you need from a tree? Let me know your favorite type in the comments section down below, and please do like this video and share with a friend. Before we get deep into this video, I want to talk to you about today's video sponsor, Tentree. Now, I am all about caring for the environment and sustainability. It's really important to me. Well, it's also important to Tentree too. Tentree is a clothing brand that uses eco-friendly recycled materials in all of their products. And for every item they sell, they plant, you guessed it, 10 trees. Now, they plant them somewhere in the world, places like Haiti, Madagascar, the United States, and Indonesia. By replenishing deforested areas, Tentree are helping to tackle rising carbon dioxide levels, and they're also securing safe homes and habitats for wildlife like lemurs. When you get your item, they also give you a token to register your tree planting impact and track where each of your trees have been planted. Tentree do more than just sell clothes and plant trees. They also work with the communities they plant in and provide education, food, and shelter. I actually really love the clothes that they have on their site. They have outerwear and activewear, and I personally love the juniper hoodie. I'd love it for all of my camping trips coming up. If you like the look of the range, we have a 20% discount code for Tentree in the description box down below. Back to trees. What would happen if there weren't any? There are around 3 trillion trees on planet Earth. Trees contribute to our global environment by producing oxygen, improving air quality, climate stability, conserving water, preserving soil, and supporting wildlife. Hurrah for trees, basically. During the process of photosynthesis, trees take in carbon dioxide and then produce the oxygen we breathe. Without them, Christmas wouldn't be the same, that's for sure, but that absolutely really would be the least of our problems. So let's start with what trees are pretty famous for, the chemical conversion thing, the way trees do convert carbon dioxide to oxygen. Now, 35% of the world's oxygen comes from trees. Without them, oxygen levels would fall and CO2 levels would increase. Obvious, right? It would take a while for humans and animals to notice it, but eventually we would start to feel lightheaded and have difficulty concentrating. People with respiratory issues like asthma and bronchitis would start dying, as would small animals. People with blood tissue issues like lupus would also see their condition significantly worsen. We would be sick, but many would survive, although the wider effects caused by a lack of oxygen and increased carbon dioxide would kill swathes of people. A lack of oxygen to breathe is one thing, but an abundance of CO2 is another. With more carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, there would be a rise in global warming, melting ice caps at a much faster rate, and this again would cause a rise in ocean levels. Eventually, coastal towns would be in jeopardy, and our natural springs could become contaminated with salt water. We don't want this. Oh, and there's the acid rain. Hip hip hurrah. That would start as a result of polluted air and cause serious damage to plant life and crops that we need to eat. It isn't just carbon dioxide filtered by trees either. They also filter carbon monoxide, sulfur dioxide, nitrogen dioxide, and ammonia. Without this filtration, these chemicals would hang about and pollute our land, making food grown in it dangerous to eat. Of course, this would also affect farming across the board, as even if we stuck to eating meat, animals are reared from the land. Aside from the gas exchange, trees perform another very key role, and that is flood prevention and the maintenance of soil quality. Trees absorb and release water at a controlled rate. Firstly, tree roots absorb water from soil. Without them, the soil would become waterlogged and prone to flooding. Tree roots also help keep soil together. Without them, there'd be land erosions and landslides. Not only would it make farming really hard, so our food supply would be diminished further, but tree trees also regulate climate. Trees release water through something called evapotranspiration, which helps cloud formation. Without clouds adding to a moist atmosphere, land would dry and there would be much less rainfall. A fun fact for you, but deforestation has often been blamed for the deaths of many ancient civilizations. The Mayans and the first populations of Easter Island were thought to have cut down too many trees that they actually affected their own climate so much that they could no longer feed themselves. A small-scale example of something that would be catastrophic on a large scale. Aside from the lack of oxygen offing animals, the lack of trees themselves would destroy habitats and food foraging options, meaning a hell of a lot of wild animals would die, if they weren't already dead. Less of a concern, but still not great, things would be loud. Trees act as a natural sound barrier and a windbreak. Things would be pretty blustery too, and I don't know about you, but wind is one of my least favorite weathers to contend with. Also, global warming as a concept is pretty damn stressful. Speaking of stress, trees and plant life have been linked to karma attitudes in humans. We like nature. Without trees around to remind us of our connection to the earth, we're gonna start getting very stressed and hot-headed in the hot weather, without much food, in the acid rain, and no pets or nature documentaries to make us feel better because they're either dead or in a very, very bad way. Trees, anyone? Am I right? Anyone wanna bring back the trees? Cause like my hand is firmly in the air, you just can't see me. Without trees, we would need to build gas exchangers, able to convert carbon dioxide and the rest of the not-so-breathable gases into oxygen. And the thing we build would also need to be able to absorb and distribute water, and have roots to sort the soil out, and be a good habitat for animals, and be pretty on the eyes. So basically, we're back to trees. There is an unsung hero to this list that I want to mention for the sake of a balanced conversation, and that is algae. Algae produces the majority of oxygen that we have in our atmosphere, although it doesn't have the microclimate benefits and soil regulation powers that trees do, but it's still important. Maybe one day I'll do a video specifically dedicated to our slimy friend. But for now, back to tree appreciation. As you have heard, life without trees would suck, if there was any left. That solves that. Thank you again to our video sponsor, Tentree. We now know that trees are pretty great. If you want to plant 10 trees or more, then do get shopping with this amazing brand. We have a 20% discount code in the description box. Also guys, don't forget to let me know what your favourite type of tree is. I'm here to hear it. Let's have some tree appreciation chat in the comments section down below. Also, I have it on good knowledge that there are a lot of tree emojis, so like, get using them. Thank you guys for watching this video. Do show me you liked it by leaving a thumbs up button and sharing it with a friend. And if you're not yet subscribed to Life's Biggest Questions, make sure you do so you're the first to hear a big answer. For now, I'm your host Rebecca Felgate. I'll catch you in the next video. But until then, stay curious, stay alert, and never ever stop questioning.